This is Lake Erie. Due to runoff for fertilizer rich in nutrients, it has been overrun by an algae bloom. This particular bloom is so intense that it can be seen from outer space. Beneath the algae, in the lake itself, fish and plant life are dying due to the blocked sunlight and lack of sufficient oxygen. This phenomenon is called eutrophication.
Eutrophication doesn't just happen in lakes and ponds. It can happen in your pool too, if you don't keep your phosphates in check. In this video, we'll go through our process for cleaning up a green pool and cover what steps can be taken to prevent blooms in the future. Before we get into our green pool cleanup method, we should mention that just because your pool is green, it doesn't mean you've got an algae bloom. In rare circumstances, your pool could turn green due to copper or iron. You can usually determine that you've got an algae bloom if your pool water is cloudy. If the pool is clear green, that usually indicates copper or iron. If you come out to the pool and it's Grinch green from algae,
I wouldn't touch you with a 39 and a half foot pole.
We've broken up our process into 2 days. The first thing you should do is clean the pool out with a net or vacuum. Remove as much debris as possible and then brush the pool thoroughly. Next, you want to test your water. Based on the readings you get, you will want to lower your pH to 7.2 and increase your chlorine level to between 10 and 15 parts per million, using a non-stabilized chlorine like liquid or calcium hypochloride. Chlorine will begin killing the algae immediately. Once you've added your acid and chlorine, pour the purge dose of phosphate remover around the perimeter of the pool. Allow the water to circulate for 10 minutes and brush really well. Then shut off circulation and leave the pool for 24 hours. When you come back on day 2, thoroughly vacuum the pool to waste and skim off any leaves or debris. Then run another test on the water. You should test the free chlorine level and check the phosphates for good measure. If the chlorine level looks good and your phosphates are below 500 parts per billion, then you're good to go. Turn on the circulation system and begin filtering. Add a purge dose of enzymes around the perimeter of the pool. Finally, test the water again to measure its LSI and adjust the pH, alkalinity, and calcium until you are within range. If you cannot make it back on day 2, you will want to add the enzymes the same day after the chlorine and phosphate remover have circulated for 10 minutes. When you make your next visit to the pool a few days or a week later, perform necessary brushing and vacuuming and backwash and clean the filter system as needed. As always, get an LSI reading on the pool and make any necessary chemical adjustments. So, that's how we clean up a green pool. But Orenda is about proactive pool care, so let's cover how to prevent a bloom in the first place. As we've covered in the previous videos, phosphates are a nutrient for algae, and the best algaecide available is chlorine. So, the best way to prevent algae is to keep your chlorine at optimum efficiency and your phosphates low. To get phosphates out of the pool, use a phosphate remover. A phosphate remover binds to phosphates and renders them inert. Usually, this means they turn white, fall out of solution, and can be filtered out of the pool. Just FYI, this is a general overview of a green pool cleanup. After hundreds of cleanups in the field, every pool is different. So if you have any questions at all, please call us and we'd love to help you. Thank you.